I don't do regret. Can't see the point. But if I did, my only regret would be that you never got to see me when I was leader. In the years before, you'd have been proud. I stirred things up, knocked heads together, got things done. Just like you. The Westminster Whirlwind, they called me. Maggie was in Downing Street sorting out the country. I was up the road doing the same thing to the most important borough in Britain.
First two things she did when she became leader of Westminster Council in 1983, sent a motivational letter to all 5,000 council workers, from the lowliest typist to the chief executive.
For those who are inefficient and don't pull their weight, there may be demotion or redundancy.
And made sure the council stopped buying its biscuits from Sainsbury's and ordered them from Tesco instead. I should have known then we'd made a massive mistake. Hello.
How breakfast tomorrow? My flat, 7:30 sharp.
Shirley, it's gone midnight.
There'll be a journalist interviewing me, so best behaviour.
By 22, I was a full-time wife and mother.
Morning, leader.
House in Hampstead Garden suburb, two children, doing brilliantly now, both of them. Are you getting all this down?
Just about.
I was raising kids, running charities, playing golf, single-figure handicap, and supporting my husband, who was working with my father to turn Tesco into Britain's biggest supermarket chain.
I wanted to ask you
about
your...
The years flew by. I turned 39, looked round, found I was a mother-in-law, for God's sake. I found it rather shattering.
Would you say you had a midlife crisis?
I prefer small meetings, less disagreements. Here, pensioners' bus passes, report with full costings on my desk ASAP.
You'll have it first thing tomorrow.
I'll have it by midday today or I'll have your job. My kitchen cabinet, my board of directors. Executive director, civil servant, so he thinks he runs the place. Politically neutral, of course, vital that.
In these political times.
Senior council official, another bloody bureaucrat.
Hello.
Fellow Tory councillors, my deputy.
Oh, her loyal details, ma'am.
Chairman of the housing committee.
I prefer chairman.
Since I became leader, I've privatised services, cut committees, streamlined departments, hired outside consultants, taken my top staff on management courses, and insisted all reports are written in plain, bloody English.
And on the seventh day, she rested.
What did you say?
I said, and all the rest, Shirley.
When I first joined the council, Westminster was flabby.
Like the whole bloody country.
Yeah, I've whipped it into shape, eh?
Oh, Shirley.
And there's always more to do. For example, do you know we own three cemeteries?
No, I
outside
know.
The borough. Up in, where are they again?
Ealing, Mill Hill and East Finchley.
They cost us a fortune. We pay 26 workers.
Skivers to a man.
To cut the grass around the graves and prune a few rhododendrons. Is that value for money?
I don't know the going...
It's not. The customers are being fleeced.
Customers?
Ratepayers, customers, service and efficiency. That's what drives me in Westminster, as it drove my father when he built Tesco.
He's clearly been a big influence
Enormous.
On your life.
He departed this life 8 years ago. But in many ways, I feel he's still with me, keeping a watchful eye.
Do you think he'd approve of you?
I've got so many memories of my dad, helping him bag raisins in one of his first shops, strolling with him down Petticoat Lane while he'd joke with his pals. I'll tell you just one. Every Friday night, my family would sit at table for the Sabbath meal. Father at the head, of course. My brother-in-law, my husband, my mother, my sister and I. The men were all traders, businessmen.
Entrepreneurs.
I'm talking. You know how my dad started out? With a barrow in Hackney and built the greatest retail empire this country has ever seen.
Everyone knows.
After the meal, the men would loosen their ties, fire up their cigars and talk. I'd sit, keep stum, hard to believe, I know, and listen. Soak it up like a sponge. Sales, stocks, prices. Forget your management training, your MBAs. This was real. Best preparation for business you could imagine. Any business, including running this borough.
Talking of Tesco, I hear you're being invited to join the board.
Oh, really? Well, my husband retires this year and a lot of shareholders want me to take his place.
Can you confirm it?
Well, I can't comment officially yet, but I'm meeting the chairman soon and after that.
Shirley, won't you sit down?
Is it because I'm a woman?
Shirley.
Because I'm a Cohen?
Don't do this,
because
please.
I'm the governor's daughter. Now, you may be chairman of Tesco's, but you're scared of me, aren't you? Because I'm exactly like my father and he was worth 10 of you.
I was fond of Jack. We respected each
or
other.
Or is it because I'm Jewish? Is that what this is?
Now you're really scraping the barrel. All right. Since you've asked me so nicely, I'll give you one good reason I don't want you on the board. You're not up to the job.
I run Westminster.
Yeah, well, we'll see how that turns out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.